Good evening, children. Welcome to online class. Learn grammar, 20th chapter, direct and indirect speech. When we report the exact words of the speaker and write them within the inverted commas, it is said to be indirect speech. Neha said, Roger Federer has won the match against Rafael Nadal. In reported or indirect speech, we do not report the exact words of the speaker, but convey the substance or meaning of a person's speech. We make some changes when we refer to time, place, personal pronouns, and possessive adjectives. That is, changes when, that is time, second place, third personal pronouns, fourth possessive adjectives. The inverted commas are not used in indirect speech. Gargi said that, so inverted comma place only, we put that, we remove inverted commas. She enjoyed watching the movie Avatar. So here, no inverted commas, that is a, here this is a indirect speech. Now we'll see how the changes in tenses take place. We change tenses when reporting in indirect speech. When the reporting verb is in the simple present or simple future tense, the verb in a reported speech does not change. Here, this is a reporting verb, says. Here, a reporting verb is will say. You have to depend on this only. Shiva says, I'm eating apple pie. Shiva says that he is eating apple pie. The reporting verb in simple present tense. Brijesh will say, I am not well and cannot exert myself. So reporting verb is in a simple future tense. So Brijesh will say that he is not well and he cannot exert himself. So as it is, you are writing. When a reporting verb is a simple present or in a simple future tense. When the reporting verb is in the past tense, the verb in reported speech is changed into the corresponding past tense. So here, that is a reporting verb past tense. So you will change the words in the sentence also. The girl said, I am scared of monsters. That is reporting verb is in the past tense. So the girl said that she was scared of monsters. I will become she, then am will become was. She was scared of monsters. Then a reporting verb said, is in the past tense, so the verb am changes to was, that is past tense, corresponding to the tense of the reporting verb. Now you see that reporting verb is in the past tense, that is said or told. So verbs change in the indirect speech as follows. Now is becomes was, are becoming were, am also becoming was becoming were. Both are there means you will change into had been. Had been is there means no change. Has, have, it will change into had. Had, no change. Do will change into did. Did will change into had done. Had done, no change. Will or shall. Will become would. Then shall will become should. Then must, had to. Then would, should, might, could, ought to. All this, they do not change at all. Now, note the changes in tenses in reported speech. Now, direct speech. If it is a simple present tense, indirect speech will become simple past tense. If it is present continuous, then it will change into past continuous. If it is present perfect, it will change into past perfect. Present perfect continuous change into past perfect continuous. Simple past will change into past perfect. Past continuous will change into past perfect continuous. Past perfect will become does not change. Past perfect continuous does not change. Will change into would. Shall will become should. Can will become could. May will become might. When we refer to universal truths of habitual action, the tense does not change. Now, example, Mohini said to her mother, the ladies have been making pickle for 10 years. That is direct. This is a direct speech. The verb have been making is in the present perfect continuous. Then how will you change? When we rewrite this in reported speech, the tense of the verb changes. So Mohini said to her mother, we'll change it to told her mother, so that the ladies had been making pickle for 10 years. So the verb had been making is in the past perfect continuous tense. Now important facts. There are three situations in which even if the reporting verb is in the past tense, we do not change the tenses in the reported speech. What are the three important facts? Even though the reporting verb is past tense, see that. The reported speech expresses a universal truth or a habitual act. When it is telling universal truth, see how it remains the same. The teacher said to us, water boils at 100 degrees centigrade. And direct speech, universal truth. So what is that? Water boils at 100 degrees, that is universal truth. So again, the teacher told us that water boils at 100 degrees centigrade only. It is here also no change because this is a truth, universal truth. The next one is the reported speech has two clauses, both in the past. If it is having both in the past and two clauses, that is Reena said to me, Neha was tired, so she did not go out to play with the friends. So that is was tired and then did not go out to play with the friends. So Reena told me that Neha was tired, so she did not go out to play with the friends. Understood the same thing. Reena told me that Neha was, so no change here. Same thing as it is here written. The reported speech describes a situation which still exists when the speech is reported. Mr. Gupta said all the flights are delayed due to heavy rains. So this one is still existing. That is all delayed. So Mr. Gupta said that all the flights are delayed due to heavy rain. We care R is used R only. Because even though that reporting word is past tense, then we use that is even though that is Mr. Gupta said that all the flights are delayed due to heavy rains. Okay. Now we always say something, but we tell somebody. Reena said that she was reading a book. Something. Reena told me that she was reading a book. That is, now this is said means what? She was reading a book. But you are telling somebody means Reena told me, that is to somebody, that is she was reading a book. Now next. Changes in words referring to time, place or position. Words indicating time, place and the position change as follows. Now direct speech, indirect speech. Here, there. Here will become there. This will change into that. This will change into those. Tomorrow will become the day after or the following day. Yesterday, so today will change into that day. Yesterday will change the day before or the previous day. Tonight will change into that night. 2 days ago will change into 2 days before. And last week will change into the previous week. Then last month will change into the previous month. Ago will change into before. Now will change into then. So now children, now you have to follow this. That is, understand this exercise. If you do, then you will come to know about that is how to write a reported speech. He said, the children became frightened when they heard a loud shriek. So he said the children became frightened when they heard a loud shriek. Then how will he change this? He said that the children had become frightened when they heard a loud shriek. The lawyer said to the judge, Sarita will tell the real story. So the lawyer told the judge, that Sarita would tell the real story. Then Maya told Ruby, the boys liked the story that was narrated yesterday. So Maya told Ruby that the boys had liked the story that had been narrated yesterday. Okay. Granny said the pickle will be ready by next week. So Granny said that the pickle would be ready by next week. Then the chemist said to the customer, Nitin always checks the expiry date of medicines that are sold. So the chemist told the customer that Nitin always checks the expiry date of medicines that are sold. Because always is there, that's why it is habitual, then you can't change the tense. Then Sheetal said to her geography teacher, Roma found the map work very confusing. And Sheetal told her geography teacher, that Roma had found the map work very confusing. The fisherman said to the customer, "The fish is fresh and will taste good." And the fisherman told the customer that the fish was ready and would taste good. The compere announced the chief guest will reach here any moment. The compere announced that the chief guest would reach there any moment. Now, change in personal pronouns and possessive adjectives. See here, then pronouns in the third person, pronouns in the third person and their possessive adjectives do not change in reported speech. She said he likes Mughalai food. He said that he likes Mughalai food. So here no change. He said her dress is ready. He said that her dress was ready. Okay, see that personal pronoun and possessive adjectives. Then pronoun of the second person, you, and its corresponding possessive adjective, you are changed into the same person as the object of the reporting verb. He said to her, you are an understanding person. Direct speech. He said to her, you are an understanding person. So that is a reporting verb. Said, her is a object. Then he told her that she was an understanding person, that is indirect. Now that the reporting verb is said, objects it her, the personal pronoun you changes to she, that is the same person as that of the subject. Rashi told him, your bag is new. Rashi told him that his bag was new. So first person pronouns I, me, we, and the possessive adjective is my, our. In a direct speech, change into the same person as the subjects of the reporting verb in an indirect speech. Now, example, he says, I am tired. So, tired, direct one. Subject is he, reporting verb is says. So, that is says is in a simple present tense. So, he says that he is tired. So, then here, because it is says there, here also no need that he is tired. Indirect. Now, that the changes. Note that I changes to he according to the person of the subject, he of the reporting verb, then says. Now, changing you, your, yours. You, your, yours. These words indicate the person being addressed. So, they change accordingly. Rita told her, your friend likes you. Rita told her that her friend liked her. Rita told her that her friend liked her. And Rita said to you, your friend likes you. So Rita told you that your friend liked you. Rita said to me, your friend likes you. Then Rita told me that her friend liked me. Now, conversion of different types of sentences and indirect speech. Now, that is conversion of different types of sentences into indirect speech. Conversion of assertive sentence into indirect speech. How will you change assertive sentence? Then read the sentences given below. The coach said to the Indian cricket team, your fielding is not up to the mark. So what is the reporting verb? Said. What is the object? Indian team. So what is the direct? Your fielding is not up to the mark. So the coach told the Indian cricket team. The coach told the Indian cricket team that their fielding was not up to the mark. Their fielding was not up to the mark. So the coach told the Indian cricket team that their fielding was not up to the mark. This is indirect. Then Chayanshi said, I am reading a comic. So Chayanshi said that she was reading a comic. Then verb said is changed to told when an object follows it. That is when the object is there, then you have to change it to then. Told. The verb said remains unchanged when it is not followed by an object. So the verb, the comma and the inverted commas are omitted and replaced by the conjunction of that. That is that. The verb said may also be replaced by other verbs like answer, state, inform, reply, mention, explain, and so on. Then the old man said to the sailor, the sea will be rough according to the weather forecast. So the old man informed the sailor that the C would be rough according to the weather report. Then you can tell that weather report that is given by the rubber weather report station. So that the old man informed the sailor that the sea would be rough then according to the weather forecast. Now tell me, that is a B, rewrite the following sentences in the reported speech. The plumber said to the lady, I will replace the tap next week. The plumber said to the lady, I will replace the tap next week. So how will you write? That is, the plumber told the lady, that he would replace the tap the following week. Next week will become following. So the plumber told the lady, I will replace the tap next week. That is, that he would replace the tap the following week. Now, second, Mohan said to the new watchman, you have to give relevant papers for police verification. So Mohan told the new watchman that he had to give relevant papers for police verification. Then Geeta met Nirmala and said, I liked the sea cost. Geeta met Nirmala and said, I liked the sun cakes that you sent. So Geeta met Nirmala and then told him that is that is Geeta met Nirmala and said that that she had liked the sun cakes that she had sent. So Geeta said Nirmala, or Geeta, sorry, Geeta told Geeta met Nirmala and told that she had liked the sun cakes that she had sent. And the next one is, Ashoka said, I have bought tickets for the lawn tennis match. Ashoka said that he had bought tickets for the lawn tennis match. What is it? Ashoka had said that he had bought tickets for the lawn tennis match. Okay. The next one is, Vinita said, the information is being downloaded from the internet. So Vinita said that the information had been downloaded. So Vinita said that the information was being downloaded from the internet. Then sixth one, Piali said to Namita, then these novels are yours. Piali said to Namita that those novels were his. Then he said to his aunt, the water filter was installed 20 years ago. He told his aunt that the water filter had been installed 20 years before. And the president said, countrymen, the health insurance scheme will be effective from tomorrow. So the president told the countrymen that the health insurance scheme would be then effective from the next day. So this is the thing. Then next, conversion of imperative sentence into indirect speech. An imperative sentence may convey a command, request, suggestion, advice, or instruction. So reporting verbs like order, tell, instruct, command are used for commands in reported speech. For request, we use reporting verbs like request, ask, plead, and beg. For advice, we are reporting verbs like suggest, advise, warn, forbid, that is in indirect speech. Now we'll see, the verb of the reported speech is changed into an infinitive. Infinitive, that is, he said to her, go there. So that is a reported speech, the verb of the reported speech is changed into infinitive. So he said, he ordered her, he said to her, go there. So the verb of the reported speech is changed into an infinitive. Infinitive means to will come. He said to her, go there. He ordered her to go there. We don't use a conjunction, example, that to introduce the reported speech. Here are some examples for these different type of imperative sentence. So different type of imperative sentence. Imperative means maybe requesting or ordering or advising. So imperative. So three things are there. Command. If the chef said to the helper, chop the vegetable quickly. So this is a direct, that is command. So the chef said to the helper, chop the vegetables quickly. So the chef ordered the helper to chop the vegetables quickly. How you can write indirect speech? The chef ordered the helper to chop the vegetables quickly. Only you have to add to. Open the inverted comma and write to there. Now request. The student said to the librarian, please allow me to go to the library. Here, please just come. So the student requested the librarian to allow him to go to the library, to allow him to go to the library. Advice. Grandma said to Kishu, avoid drinking chilled water as it will further harm you, your sore throat. So grandma advised Kishu to avoid drinking chilled water as it would further harm his sore throat. Okay, now next. When imperatives, let him, are changed into indirect speech, we are reporting verbs like suggest, proposed, should, to let, and might. He said, let us go to the market. Direct speech. He suggested that they should go to the market. He suggested that they should go to the market. The next one. The chairman of the water board said, let us adopt the method of water harvesting and try to solve the water crisis. So the chairman of the water board proposed to adopt a method of water harvesting and try to solve the water crisis. Now, verbs like advised, commanded, requested, cried out, exclaimed, offered, conveyed. The mode, purpose, and the intention of the speaker. Read the following sentences and identify whether they are command, request, or advice. Then rewrite them in the reported speech. The class monitor said, boys stand in a queue. So the class monitor said, boys stand in a queue. So the class monitor commanded the boys to stand in a queue. To stand only should come. The class monitor commanded the boys to stand in a queue. Next, the teacher said, children, don't get friendly with the strangers. The teacher advised the children not to get friendly with the strangers. The lifeguard said to the swimmer, don't swim today as the sea is rough. The lifeguard the lifeguard then advised the swimmer not to swim that day as the sea was rough. The blind man said to the passerby, please help me cross the street. And the blind man requested the passerby to help him to cross the street. And the lady said to the green grocer, give me a bunch of fresh coriander leaves. The lady requested the green grocer, please give, that is, it is there already in the sentence. So the lady requested the green grocer to give her a bunch of fresh coriander leaves. Requested to give a bunch of coriander leaves. Then the electrician told the lady, don't use the inverter because its wire is loose. So then the that is the electrician used the electrician advised the lady not to use the inverter because the wires are loose. So the electrician The electrician request advised the lady not to use the inverter because its wire was loose. Is loose, yeah, was loose. Then Rapunzel said to the evil witch Gothel, please let me go out of the tower and allow me to send me by. So here, that is, the Rapunzel said to the evil with Gothel, evil witch Gothel. So Rapunzel said to the evil witch Gothel, please let me go out of the tower and allow me to visit the city. So Rapunzel said will become suggested or requested. Rapunzel requested, so please is come now, then requested. So Rapunzel requested the evil witch Gothel to let her go out of the tower, and allow her to visit the city. Now, ninth one, he said, let us relax in the garden. Then eighth one, Harry Potter said to his friend, the evil one will attack us when we are unaware. So Harry suggested then his friend that they should fight with the evil one together. So they would fight because already, what is there? Will. Then here you have to write would. Harry Potter requested Harry Potter suggested his friend that the Harry Potter suggested that is they should fight with the evil one together. So what he said, Harry Potter suggested his friend that the evil one would attack them when they were unaware. So here he said, let us relax in the garden. He said, that is, he suggested that they should relax in the garden. Then she said, let us eat noodles. Then she suggested that they should eat noodles. Now, conversion of interrogative sentence into indirect speech. Then the reportive verb, the reporting verb is usually changed into the verbs like ask, inquire, and demand. So the inverted commas and the mark of interrogation are omitted. And the structure of the reported speech is changed from interrogative form to assertive form. Then D. When we have WH interrogatives, words like who, what, whose, whom, where, when, then why, which, or how. At the beginning of a question, the no to conjunction is used after the reporting verb. No conjunction is used after the reporting verb. See here, we use the conjunctions whether or if to introduce the reported speech. If the question begins with the auxiliary verbs such as are, is, am, was, where, do, does, did, have, had, will, shall, can, or then may, can or may also. Here are a few examples to show the application of the rules mentioned below. That is, Sana said, mother, where have you kept my new pair of jeans? That is direct speech. And Sana asked her mother where she had kept the new pair of jeans. That is indirect. Murdala asked Manisha, did you buy the magic show tickets? Then Murdala asked Manisha, Murdala asked Manisha, because the question is coming, if she had, that is the did is there, if she had bought the magic show tickets. This is indirect speech. Now questions beginning with the will, shall, or change into indirect speech by using whether or if, and will or shall are changed into would or should. Here, Sita said to him, will you play cricket? That is indirect speech. And Sita asked him whether, what you should use, whether. Or you can write if. any one of the two, you can write whether or if. He would, so will become would. He would play that day, so today will become that day. So Sita, because it's a question, Sita asked him whether he would play that day. So no question mark, my dear, only full stop, indirect speech. Then questions beginning with the can, may, or changes similarly to indirect speech by using whether, if, and can may be written, rewritten as a could or might. The same thing, you can use whether or you can use if, but can will change into could and may will change into might. He said to his sister, can you sing like a professional singer? That is direct speech. And he asked his sister whether she could sing like a professional singer. See, children, then a question tag also is coming here. Sometimes, here question tag, sometimes a statement is made by the speaker and he or she asks for a confirmation by attaching a question tag. Though question tag asks the opinion of the addressed person, they take his or her agreement for granted. While changing such questions to indirect speech, the tag is expanded to a full question and the question mark is left out. Here, the chemistry teacher said to her students, you have understood the experiment, haven't you? So like the teacher is asking, that is direct speech. The chemistry teacher asked the students if they had understood the experiment. So this is an indirect speech, like this. Mother said to her friend, my daughter sang well, didn't she? Mother asked her friend if her daughter had sung well. That is, sang will become had sung well. Okay, based on the guidelines stated above, rewrite the following interrogative sentences into reported speech. Now, Mukta said to her friend, you can drive in congested areas, can't you? So, yeah, that is can't you. Then, how will you change? Mukta said to her friend, you can drive in congested areas, can't you? Mukta asked her friend, said will become asked her friend, if she can will become could, no? If she could drive in congested areas. So that was congested areas. That's all. Here, can't you is left. So Mukta asked her friend if she could drive in congested areas. Full stop only, no question mark. Father said to Samyak, can we leave for the airport immediately? Then father asked Samyak if they could leave for the airport immediately. Mr. Roy said to the receptionist, when can I meet the principal? Mr. Roy asked the receptionist when he could meet the principal. When he could meet the principal. Swati said to Neera, do you go to the gym every day? Swati asked Neera if she went to the gym every day. Aditya said to Vikram, which shirt is new? So Aditya asked Vikram which the new shirt was. So like, and when you answer, no, how you will start like that, which shirt is new will change it. Which the new shirt was. My friend said, do you worry a lot over petty things? So my friend asked if I worried a lot over petty things. The librarian said to Vinita, you returned the book, didn't you? So the librarian asked Vinita if she had returned the book. Full stop. The teacher said, why were the Americans opposed strongly in Vietnam? Then the teacher asked why the Americans were opposed strongly in Vietnam. Now, conversion of exclamatory sentences into indirect speech. Now, we'll see how the exclamatory sentences change. The exclamatory sentences are changed into assertive sentences. First one, the reporting verb is changed into exclaimed with joy, sorrow, delight, surprise, anger, or fear. So, but exclaimed with all these things, anyone you can use. The conjunction that is used to introduce the reported speech, that is used. All exclamations and interjections are left out. No marks there. Their sense is conveyed by means of adverbs or adverbial clauses. Then fifth one, the sentences which are incomplete or express sudden feelings are changed into full sentences. Here are some interjections with their meanings. See here, hurrah, good, splendid, ha, bravo, express joy, pleasure or admiration. The word alas expresses grief or pain. What and oh express surprise. Ooh expresses a disgust. Well done and thank goodness are interjection phrases. Read the sentences given below and note how they are rewritten in reported speech. She said, oh, what a lovely dress. This is direct speech. Then how will you write? She exclaimed with admiration that it was a lovely dress. Already we have seen, no? Exclaimed with a delight, with a joy, with a sorrow, with surprise, with anger, or with fear. So all this now here, happiness. So she exclaimed with admiration that it was a lovely dress. They said, alas, we have lost our way in the forest. They exclaimed with regret that they had lost their way in the forest. He said, oh, I have met you after a long time. And he exclaimed with surprise that he had met her after a long time. Now, conversion of a wish or desire and verbs like a hear and a think into indirect speech. When an optative sentence, that is a sentence expressing a wish or a desire, is changed into indirect speech, the following guidelines are to be followed. The exclamatory sentence is changed into assertive sentence, first thing. And we change the reporting verbs into words like bless, pray, wish to convey the meaning of the complete expression. The conjunction that is used in the statement that we have to write. He said, may you succeed in your venture, my daughter. And he wished that his daughter might succeed in her venture. Akbar said to Himesh, a very happy birthday. Akbar wished Himesh a very happy birthday. Verbs like hear, think are also used in indirect speech to report one's thoughts, ideas, or what one has heard. Example, Reena said, I think the book is too expensive. So Reena thought that the book was, because think is there, no? Reena thought that the book was so too expensive. Television news, a heavy rain, heavy snowfall is predicted in the Kashmir Valley. So I heard on television that heavy rainfall is predicted in the Kashmir Valley. Now, rewrite the following sentences into reported speech. The Prime Minister said, alas, the great leader Mahatma Gandhi is no more. So the Prime Minister exclaimed with sorrow that the great leader Mahatma Gandhi was no more. Vivek said, hurrah, I have scored the highest marks in class in the annual examination. So Vivek exclaimed with joy that he had scored the highest marks in class in the annual examination. The priest said to Malini, may God shower his blessings on you. The priest prayed that God might shower his blessings on Malini. See that, how it changed. Aruna said a lot of happiness and cheer to the newly married couple. Then Aruna wished a lot of happiness and cheer to the newly married couple. My mother wished best of luck for your medical entrance exams. My mother wished me luck for my medical examination, medical entrance exam. The player said, bravo, we have scored more goals than the other team. The players exclaimed with joy that they had scored more goals than the other team. Mohit said, I think the movie will be interesting. Mohit thought, because think has come now, Mohit thought that the movie would be interesting. Then the radio news. 8th one. A cure for cancer has been invented. I heard on the radio that a cure for cancer had been invented. Okay. Now, conversion of mixed types of sentences. That is, a direct speech in a passage may consist of statement plus command, statement plus question, statement plus request, question plus command. When a passage contains a mixed type of sentences, the following changes are made. We do not change the order of the ideas or the language of the original passage. Each sentence is changed according to the rules for that kind of sentence. So the reporting verb is changed according to the rule for the sentence, for that sentence, but it is not essential to introduce every sentence with the words like he or she said like that. Now read the following sentences carefully and note the different kinds of sentences have been changed into indirect speech. Example, he said, are you tired today? Let us take the children to the zoo. Tomorrow is a holiday, so we will be relaxed. So the above passage has three kinds of sentences. Are you tired today is an interrogative sentence. Let us take the children to the zoo, imperative sentence. And tomorrow is a holiday, so we will be relaxed. It is an assertive sentence. We will follow the rules explained earlier and rewrite the passage in indirect speech. He asked if I was tired that day. He suggested that we take the children to the zoo as the next day was a holiday, so we would be relaxed. And example, she said, it's very hot today, isn't it? Summer is here to stay and it is the right time to go for a swim. Let us also buy mangoes, ice cream and juice cans to beat the heat. So direct. She said that it was very hot that day and the summer was there to stay. And next one, it was the right time to go for a swim, she added. And she also suggested that we should buy mangoes, ice cream and juice cans to beat the heat. Okay, this is the way. And the third example, my friend said, oh, what a pleasant surprise to have you in my house. I will prepare pasta and risotto for you. Let us watch a movie in my home theater. So direct. Then how will you change it into indirect speech? My friend exclaimed with joy that it was a pleasant surprise to have me in her house. She said that she would prepare pasta and risotto for me. And suggested that we should watch a movie in her home theater. Then the fourth one, Mother Teresa said, let us touch the dying, the poor, the lonely and the unwanted according to the graces we have received. And let us not be ashamed or slow to do the humble work. So that is direct speech. So Mother Teresa said that we should touch the dying, the poor, the lonely, and the unwanted according to the graces we had received. And we should not be ashamed or slow to do the humble work. Now, this is indirect speech. Now, example, daughter, Papa, please buy a mobile phone for me. Then father, what is the need of a mobile when you can use the landline? Daughter, my all friends have mobiles. I want one for myself. Mother, I will buy it for you after your final exams. So how will you change this? The daughter requested her father to buy a mobile phone for her. Father asked her, what was the need of a mobile when she could use the landline? The daughter replied that all her friends had mobiles. She wanted one for herself. And father agreed and said that he would buy it for her after her final exam. Okay, this is the way. Now coming the exercise. Now read the following text and rewrite them in a reported speech. Martin Luther King said, I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit together at the table of brotherhood. So how we can change? Martin Luther King said that he had a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners would be able to sit together at the table of brotherhood. Okay. Mother Teresa said, one day I was walking down the streets of London and I saw a man quite drunk. He looked sad and miserable. I went right up to him and held his hand. He said, oh, after so long, I feel the warmth of a human hand. And then his face lit up. I only want to say that small things done in great love bring joy and peace. So Mother Teresa said that one day she had been walking down the streets of London, and she had seen a man quite drunk. He had looked sad and miserable. She had gone right up to him and had held his hand. He exclaimed with the surprise, that after so long, he had felt the warmth of a human hand, and then his face lit up. She only wanted to say that small things done in great love bring joy and peace. Okay. Now, third one. After some time, Birbal walked up to one of the kings and greeted him. The king said, how did you recognize the real king? Birbal said, After I observed the other three kings, I found them watching you very closely and trying to imitate your action and manners. But when I looked at you, I could see a calm and a relaxed demeanor that indicated the true nature of a king. The king was pleased and rewarded him. So that is, after some time, Birbal walked up to one of the kings and greeted him. The king was surprised and asked him how he had recognized the real king. Birbal replied that after he had observed the other three kings, he found them watching him very closely and trying to imitate the actions and the manners. But when he had looked at him, he could see a calm and a relaxed demeanor that indicated the true nature of a king. The king was pleased and rewarded him. Now, last one, Neha. I will be late from school today. Mother, do you have an extra class? Neha, no. Our PA teacher has organized games for us. Mother, try to be back as early as possible. Yes, mother. Neha informed her mother that she would be late from school that day. Her mother asked her if she had an extra class. Neha said no to her mother and informed that her PA teacher had organized games for them. Her mother told her to return as early as possible. Neha said yes to her mother. Okay, children, I believe you have understood. Now you go through again and again and try to learn active awesome passages. Very easy.